What up, it's your buddy Mark, your friendly neighborhood YouTuber. I did that Onyx on 50 Cent because I thought it was interesting that was like 50 Cent's first video was with Onyx, like on an album that I listened to so much when I was a kid and I had no clue who 50 was at the time, and it was my favorite song on the album. But now we're going to get to his first album, not Get Rich or Die Trying, Guess Who's Back. This was like the first album he put out, and it's really a mixtape because there's songs on here before he got shot, and there's songs on here after he got shot. It's like a year gap between. But this one, I think, was before, I'm not positive, but How to Rob, and he's funny in this one. It's like Eminem funny, kind of like taking jabs, little jabs at everybody. Let's get to the song.
This
is the only really funny song by 50.
If my record don't sell, I'ma rob and steal. You better recognize, nigga, I'm straight from the street. These industry niggas are starting to look like something to eat. I snatched Kim, tell Puff, you wanna see her again? Dance your ass down to the nearest ATM. I have dreams of fucking the R&B bitch, but I wake up early and bounce with all that shit when I apply pressure. Son, it ain't even funny. I'm about to stick Bobby for some of that Whitney money. Brian McKnight, I could get the nigga anytime. Have kids sweating, staring down the barrel on my nine. Since these Harlem World niggas seem to all be fam, I put the gun to call Dan, tell him, tell your man, may see that come up that box now. I mean, right now.
He's taking shots at everyone right now, man. It's funny. It's just little jabs, not disses.
Only excuse for being broke is being in jail. An entertainer can't make bail. He broke as hell. A raw ODB, but that'd be a waste of time. Probably have to clap him.
Wow. This is before ODB passed. This is old. This had to be before he got shot. He said, I'd wait, ODB, old dirty bastard from Wu-Tang, instead of a waste of time.
Send a drop for 4 blocks, plotting the tips up for that rock, corrupt cop. What nigga just sold, like 4 million, got something to live for. Don't want a nigga putting four through that Bentley coupe.
Jay-Z was the only one that got a little mad about it, the song. They're actually performing together not long after, at like a Monster Jam. And 50 Cent was the opening act, and Jay-Z was going on after. And Jay-Z saw him behind the stage and said, I'm going to get you for that song. And 50 didn't know him, man, right then and there. And he goes out on stage. He goes, I'm about a dollar. Who the fuck is 50 Cent? And 50 Cent actually thanked him for that. He said, all those people cheering. He said, they didn't know what 50 Cent was yet, so he didn't care. But anyway, Jay-Z's only got a little mad.
Get on the ground, you ain't with Mary no more. Where you getting chips from now? I've been steaming on Tone and Pope since they found me. Steve don't have to wear that platinum shit around me. I'm a klepto, not for real, son, I'm sick. I'm about to stick slick brick for all that old school shit. Right now I'm bent, when I get like this, I don't think about the big Stevie J. Take off that tight ass mic, a raw pun without a gun. That just keeps it running.
Said I'll rob pun without a gun. He weighs 400 pounds. He gonna catch me if I run. So the course is sounding, this ain't serious. Ain't serious.
Still
Jada. He said to Missy, give me the cash and you put the hot dog down. I don't know, DMX does not seem like someone you want to fuck with, but he is 50 Cent. That would be like a great boxing match, boy. He just said RZA, Ghostface, all Wu-Tang members, those funny rings they wear. I love boy. Blackstreet, they're no diggity, no doubt. They're like one at one day. Produced by Dre, though. That's funny, like Robin Givens, that was Tyson's wife who took all his money, or a lot of his money somehow, I forget, it was a long time ago, and then 50 Cent ended up buying Mike Tyson's house. They had everything, they had a bowling alley, had a shooting range, had a movie theater, had a disco club. It was out in Connecticut, and people still criticize 50, you don't live in the hood no more. Why the hell would you, when you can have a house like that? It's the scene. That nigga still eating off big first LP. I had busted a whole flip mode on the flow. He asked me if I had enough. I told him, give me some more. Feeling this? Been waiting for the sequel. I gotta get Kirk Franklin for Robin's Hard Sequel. He's just saying, I'm gonna cut it off, but he just keeps saying, I'm gonna rob anyone. I don't care who you are, or if you got the money, I'm gonna rob you, basically. He's only joking, and of course he said it. This ain't serious, whatever. But I know he said something with Eminem in there, and I missed it. I'm pissed about that. I probably was talking right during when he said it. But it's ironic that he even threw in Eminem way before they worked together. But I hope you like that, because it's not really a well-known song, and 50 is not known for being funny, and he's a funny dude, you can tell in interviews, but as far as his music, he doesn't really make funny songs. This was one of them. It reminded me of, like, the real Slim Shady Stand Up, or, Without Me, I mean, one of those songs where he's taking jabs at all the celebrities. All right, peace.